A minus B times A plus what? So how do I multiply this? Multiply. A times A is what? Plus A what? Minus A what? Minus B what? Equal to A what? And what happened? AB and then AB here. And minus what? B what? Did I start at the right side? Did I get to the side I want? Then in this stage we say QED. QE what? Maybe look up what QED mean right now. Look it up. What does QED mean? But we're going to use this again. Why do we say this? Because when you take calculus and then your professor said QED, and you don't know what QED means, you won't look like the fool of the room. We don't want that, especially if you take pre-calc, Calvin, U of H, or Rice, or this is standard. That's what we call teaching up to standard. That's the standard. Okay? So what do you do with the identity? You verify. You go from the complicated to the less what? Complicated. So we're going to see a lot of trig what? Let me write a couple of things for you. Those are the areas in trig that you're going to need later down the road. You're going to need to know some trig fundamentals. Trig what?
Fundamentals.
Which means unit circles, ratios, drawing a diagram, finding the missing side, finding all that stuff we did in chapter what? 4. You also need to know some trig graphing. Some trig what?
Graphing.
Graphing. And transformation, which we will do together. You also need to know solving trig equations. Solving what?
Trig equations.
Equations. You also need to know how to verify trig identities. Trig what?
Identity.
Identity, which means working with your algebra. You also need to know a little bit about trig applications for non-right triangles. How do we apply trig if the triangle is not a right triangle? Which means laws of cosine, laws of sine, area of triangle. Area of what? Among all those, I'm gonna circle three that are very, very important. Well, no one is gonna do well in Calvin if you don't know how to do a fundamental. Solving trig equations and verifying trig what? Later down the road, I'll give you a homework here that's going to keep you busy for about a year or so. It has a lot of problems, but that's on the way. Let's see some trig identities before you see the magic epsilon, shall we? Is that okay? You want this picture or this? You might get it.
Trig fundamentals.
Trig fundamental means knowing where the angle is, knowing your unit circle, knowing how to find the trig ratio, knowing under what condition the angle is in quadrant 2, knowing the reference angle, all that stuff. That's okay. But let me just do some. Look at example number 9. Is this an identity or an expression? How do you know it's an identity? Well, at least we hope it's a what? Identity. Because why? So they give us the left side and the what?
Intersects.
And the what? So how am I gonna prove this? What do you think is easier for me, to start from the left side or the right side?
Your left side, more complicated.
Of course. So I'm gonna start from here. So negative 1 over what?
Sine squared x minus 1, which is equal to cosine theta.
So let's see. I want to start here and show that it gets you this, right? So what if I have cosine squared x plus sine squared x equal to what?
Plus 1.
But I want sine squared minus what?
1.
So I want the 1 to go here and the cosine to go where? Right? So you just go for that. Sine squared x minus what?
Minus 1 equal to cosine.
Equal no. Negative cosine square what? That's what, you see how we talked about being good in algebra? That's all it takes for you to mess up the problem. So now this will be equal to negative 1 over negative what?
Cosine squared x.
But negative over negative is positive, right? So this is actually 1 over what?
Cosine squared x.
Cosine squared x. But this is the reciprocal of cosine squared. What is the reciprocal of cosine squared?
Secant
square what? Did I get to the right side? Yes or no?
Yes.
Then Q, E what? Notice when you do this type of problem.
What did Q, E stand for?
Which was to be demonstrated.
Yeah.
In Latin. Erratus, erratus demonstratus.
Yes.
Which was to be shown or which was to be demonstrated? Notice when you do something like this, you can, but my favorite is this. One time I had a student, this is what she does. She writes this, and she writes the answer, and then she writes next to it, QE what? I said, well, that's wonderful. I mean, I like your magic skills. How do we get from here to here? What steps? She's like, well, it works, doesn't it? I'm like, yes, it does work. You're right, it does work. But you haven't shown how it works. And for the longest, she didn't understand the question. What is the question here? Verify. How do you verify? Show it worked. I need to know the steps, right? So watch here. Also here, what did they say? Prove the what? And I think it's very obvious here. That you want to start on what side?
The left.
If you start from here, trying to generate all this, good luck, we have problems. So, sine x, cosine what?
Cosine.
Over what?
1 minus cosine squared x.
That conjures up also, again, the fact that we have what?
Cosine squared x plus sine
squared x. Cosine squared x plus what? Equal to what? Equal to what? So what does that mean? I want, watch what I want. 1 minus what? So one way also you can do this without troubling yourself by solving. You see, anytime you see have 1, you replace 1 with cosine squared plus what?
Plus 1.
Plus, no, replace the 1 itself with cosine plus what?
Oh,
sine, right? So if I do that, what would happen? This is sine x, cosine what? How do I replace the 1 with cosine squared x plus what? Minus cosine squared what? You see how I replace the 1 with this? Right?
Okay.
So what happened? Now, cosine squared and cosine squared are gone, right?
Yes.
And then also sine and sine are gone. So what's left? Cosine over what?
Cosine.
Over what?
Sine x.
Sine x. So what is cosine over sine x? Cotangent what? Q, E, number function what?
D.
This is again sine and sine squared, right?
Oh, yeah, whatever.
Is that okay? No. working with you. No, Martina. Let's start with the left side. Cotangent A times 1 plus what? Over what? Over what?
Tangent A.
Tangent A. If you look at your identity, you remember that I gave you two pages that have the circle and the identity, right? Somebody look up what is 1 plus tangent squared. What is 1 plus tangent squared? Tell me what is 1 plus tangent squared?
Secant squared.
Secant squared. So I'm going to write this. Hopefully that will help you. In about a minute or two, I'm going to tell you how you can generate all this. So 1 plus tangent squared, A is what? Secant squared A, is that what it is?
Yes.
Yeah? Yeah?
Yeah.
Okay. So, let me start with this, see where that be. So that will be cotangent A times secant what? Over what?
Tangent A, but can you make the tangent A secant positive?
Tangent what?
Tangent A.
Now, it's better to make everything in terms. Sine of what and what?
Cosine.
Okay? So let's pay attention. What's cotangent anyway?
Cosine of sine.
It is cosine, cosine over what?
Sine.
Over sine. And what is secant squared?
1 over
what?
Cosine.
Sure. Cosine squared what? Over what? Over what?